Our next presentation will be in São Paulo, our next Urban Age city, and I'd like to introduce Helena Maria Gasparian, the Special Advisor on International Relations to the Governor of the State of São Paulo.
Good morning. I'll start by saying that São Paulo is a rapid growth city that has, we hope, reached its peak. The city of São Paulo, you can see in yellow, has 11 million inhabitants, and the greater São Paulo, composed by 39 other cities, has 19.8 million inhabitants. I worked for 2 years in the municipality of São Paulo proper, the municipality of São Paulo. And as an immigrant city, it is a city full of people that come there to build a better future. So you have a whole community that has a different past but looks forward to building a future together. This is very difficult. For the 2 years I've worked there, I've seen the difficulty of planning for a city this size. First of all, the municipality is only responsible for the core of the city. The other 39 cities, there's no mechanism of coordination between them. Second, most of the work is to see what is missing and where it's missing. So you sort of dialogue with the past. The greatest effort of the administration is to put children in school. Actually, São Paulo has 1,120,000 children in the primary school, which is the responsibility of the city. Just next year, there's not enough schools, so you study in shifts. And next year, the third shift will be abolished. So each school will only have two shifts of 4 hours each, right? There are still 1,000 schools that have the third shift. Where in health, in housing, there's an enormous backlog that has to be filled. And what municipal planners are most engaged in is this sort of pressure that you could say from the past, and also a pressure from the present, because every week, usually especially in São Paulo, you have surveys of what is bothering the population. And there is an enormous pressure on some issues of housing, of transport, of flood, problems of flood, problems in specific slums that the administrations try to cope with. There's a limited amount of money, and so this money has to be best distributed between the several needs that a city like São Paulo, and perhaps like Mumbai, or perhaps like many others in South America, have. So it's not a question of a master plan for the future with huge investments. One, because transport, the infrastructure of transport is not a responsibility of the city. It belongs to the state government. Also, water and sewage and electricity are not in the city's responsibility, also the state's responsibility. So what I would like to say, I think it's planning in a city like that, in an administration that tries to have an open line with the population, is the first step is an effort to sum up the deficiencies that the city have, or the debits that the city has towards the poorer population. This is where it is. This is the state of São Paulo, which is the richest of Brazil, as you can see. And the city is 92.46% urbanized. And it has at some stage stopped growing, which has enabled us. No. Oh. It's not moving. Ah, sorry. It is a city of mixture, a city of a lot of big festivities, and they have to be planned too. So the city allows for a number of occupation of the city. No, it's, sorry. Well, I forget about it. You had seen the favela, the slum of Paraisopolis. Well, you have to deal with the present problems with an illuminated eye, or with an eye that does not condense itself to the problem it is having. So one of the questions is housing. You've seen slums that we have that are here. This is the slum of Paraisopolis. This is the classical photograph of the inequality in São Paulo. This slum is not going to be, and this is the slums that I wanted to talk about. You can see the difference between one and the other. The first one is when people first arrive in the city, and the second one is Paraisopolis already. This is all Paraisopolis. And you can see that the urbanization of it, it's practically urbanized. It has water, it has electricity, it has sewage from this year on. The state government, the city government is investing $500 million in, in it, in schools inside it, in healthcare inside it. And there will be roads built inside so it can join the urban fabric. It's right next to one of the richest neighborhoods in São Paulo, but it's already integrated community. It's not going to be moved. And you can see that inside it's sort of paved and so on. This is another one. This is Heliópolis. Parts of a housing estate you can see over there that were put up because so as to allow for the roads to be built inside it. And this is a private organization that inside Heliópolis is painting the houses. It's an NGO that is painting the houses to better the way of life. This is really inside the favela. And this is one of the biggest problems we have in São Paulo. And again, it's outside the city of São Paulo. It's the invasions in the dam that provide São Paulo with water. This is the object of a long reflection between state government and city government and even some federal agencies, because the invasion is starting to pollute the waters that we drink. And it's a huge one. This is how it looks. So in other words, I think that planning in a big city is important for transport. But the city of São Paulo itself has not the power to have to do the guidelines for the greater São Paulo. You need a metropolitan authority to do that. On the other hand, we have the city itself opted for not taking out the big favelas, because that would put a further strain on transport and leave these populations, both of Heliópolis and Paraisópolis, where they are. Thank you very much.